What was I pulling up? Oh yeah, we're gonna go through the games. Yes, 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 yes.
Got the label. Thank you. I appreciate it.
All right, what kind of game do you want to go through?
We've got lots of variants. You got the Intellivision, the 360, the PS2, the NES, the SNES, the N64. What do you want to start with? We can eventually make our way through a lot. What games do we want to look through first?
Woohoo!
Go through the cool ones. Well, there's cool games from every category, so that doesn't too much narrow it down. You know? Yeah. I believe it was Z that was wanting me to go through the games. NES games first? Okay.
Okay, let's go through. We'll go oldest to nudist. I mean, yeah, that'd be NES to nudist to NES.
To start, I got some good ones. I've got the Nintendo Entertainment System. Oh god, this is one of my shittier ones. But fully in the box, I have golf. Motherfucking golf. It's golf, bro. It's fucking golf. And it's still got, you open it up, got it in there. Mint condition. Nobody wants it. It's got... Oh, it's got all of it. Hold on. Yeah, oldest to nudist. That's what I'm saying. Got the sleeve. Put the game in for display. And I got the little golf booklet that explains how to play golf. That, pop it back in there. Next one's a little bit more pricey for obvious reasons and quality. You've got Super Mario Brothers 3, fully in box for the NES. Boop. I'm gonna pop that one out, that bad boy. This one might be my favorite that I have. Boom, bam, bomb. Well, yeah, obviously it'd be more of a... I didn't buy these so I could resell them. I bought them because I like old video games. Yeah, I didn't buy these as if they were NFTs. Get the book. And you got the old fucking classic. Get our boy neatly in there. Now, this I would play every day after work at Dairy Queen. So after that, let's keep going through. A lot of these are throwaways just because I bought like in bulk. You've got, let me know if you've played these by the way. We got Henry Shredden. I don't think I've even seen videos of that one. Henry Shredden, made in Japan. We've got, I love these old fucking games, dude. I gotta stream some of these. You have Anticipation. And Nintendo's first board game, which just has a picture of real ass people. I got the Super Mario Brothers plus Duck Hunt, the OG like that launched the entire thing. I got Blades of Steel, a hockey game by Konami. I wonder if that company is still relevant. Anybody ever hear of Konami? We got Kings of the Beach. Dude, I love the old art for these. It looks nothing like how the video game looks. But I'm a fan. Oh, we got more golf, dude. We got Jack Nicklaus' greatest 18 holes of major championship golf. Dude, there were just so many games for this. Everyone was making a game. That's why I like the Nintendo 64, because if you want to collect it, I believe there's only exactly 296 games. Like, the PS2 is in the thousands of thousands. Oh, what up, Sierra? How you doing there? No! I almost knocked him all over. We have Elevator Action. That's all it says. That's all it says. I should have a month where we play, try and get through every game on the shelf, because there's so many that I haven't seen. But then there's some classics. You know, you got like Paperboy. That's a classic. Paperboy is one that like most gamers know. Similar to Gyromite, which I got for 50 cents, as you can see. Chatters love Gyromite, and that is the extent of my NES collection. I've also got the OG Nintendo in my living room all hooked up. You meant the AMA part. Let me turn on the Kirby music. Feel weird asking this? Oh, God. I guarantee you chat's already asked it.
Send it. Send it. Chat can ask absolutely anything. I may not... There are some things I won't tell chat for private reasons.
Am I gay?
No. And I do know this for sure. I'm a very open male. Contrary to some males. I have looked into it, I will say, as a very open person. I've said this. I do not comprehend how women find men attractive. And not just to be like, because I don't want to be gay. But, like, I have, like, the penis is the most foul thing on planet Earth. Like, I want to give 7 blessings to any woman who has entered a penis into their mouth. God love them. I don't know how it happens. It looks so disgusting. Like, if aliens came down from Earth and they said, give us your most attractive being, I feel like a penis could not be attached to them. Wait, which clip did you see? Oh, it's about the Is It Okay to Be Gay clip? How did that come up? So that wasn't me asking that. That's a story about my first sleepover. And I'm quoting my friends. Oh, okay. That wasn't me having a moment with chat. That's a story. That's a story. Yeah. That's why I'm like, thank God for gay men fucking taking other dudes off the market. Because we got to take women as we got them, you know? I think you're talking about where I have the bowl cut. And I just go, is it okay to be gay? Yeah, that's a very old story. I was very anxious. I was silent, Trey. And I went over to my friend Kenneth's house. And we hung out. And he was, like, overly masculine. Like, not naturally, I mean. But, like, how do you put it? Like putting on a front kind of thing. Like, I sat down. And he goes, we're gonna play wrestling. And I go, I love wrestling. Cool, you have the new WWE game? I have the new WWE game. And then we proceeded to spend 2 hours while he made every female character with the most gigantic breasts. He'd be like, dude, boobs, right? And I was like, yeah, I like boobs. And he would just be like, look how big we can make them. Boobs! But for like 2 hours, like it was so forced kind of thing. And I was just like, all right, man. Yeah, those are boobs. Yeah, those are boobs. This is fun. Those are boobs. He's like, booba, booba. And I was like, yeah, those are boobs, man. Ooh. And we hung out, we ate some food, and I laid down on the floor, and he laid down in his bed, and I was laying there, and I couldn't sleep, because it's my first sleepover, I'm uncomfortable, like, I don't know a lot of things, I'm not a people person, I'm not discovered I'm an introvert yet, and right as I'm about to fall asleep my first sleepover, I'm having panic attack on panic attack on panic attack, this guy asks, and it's a respectful question, and I feel bad for not having a good answer at the time, but again, I was like 10. I live in Missouri. I don't know things yet about the world. And I just hear 5 feet away, is it okay to be gay? Or no, he goes, hey, Trey. I go, yeah, Kenneth. He goes, is it okay to be gay? And I just went, yep. And then I just was like, and then he went to ask, like, follow-up questions, and I was like, I'm falling asleep. I'm panicking. I'm having a panic. I can't. I don't know. I went from, like, first sleepover to, like, helping somebody out of the closet. Like, from 0 to 100 so fast. And I don't know what to do. I, like, went shut down mode. It was unfortunate. Very not gay, by the way. Was just probably having questions at the time. Great guy. I've spoken with. Definitely knows where he's at now. But was probably just having questions at the time, like most young boys do, you know? But we just don't talk about it. I always looked into it. I was like, God, the male species is just not it. I don't know. We need a better PR guy. Got any good Game Boy Advance games to play? Yes. I gotta find those. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I don't seem like I didn't know the answer to the question. It was just like, this is my first experience sleeping in somebody else's house, and I'm now doing this. Like, it was just such a jump. Yeah, ask me anything. Ask me anything. Yeah. There's probably, like, some dudes, you know? But I feel like to have that... Everyone has their own reason for using, like, the bi label. I feel like for me to use that, I'd have to be, like... For me personally. I don't know. There's always an exception to the rule is how my brain works. Like, Jason Momoa, if he knocked on my door and was like, can I ravage your ass? I'd be like, it'd be a shame to say no. You know? It's like if you could touch the sun, you know? You'll die if you touch the sun, but you get to touch the sun. Do you see that thing? Exactly. It is so foul and aggressive looking. Yeah, to a different type of uncomfortable. Yeah. Yeah. What did the wheel land on? Wheel landed on phone a friend and chatter tweets for me. But chat wanted me to go through my video game collection, so we're doing that right now. We've been doing a lot of just chatting today. It's been fun, and then we'll play games a little bit later. But yeah, ask me anything while I go through these games. We got Tetrisphere. Yeah. Don't do it too often, but like I don't usually put it in the title, but it's always there. You can always ask me anything. I just don't usually advertise it. Put Ranch on it? No. These games I like. So we've already went through NES and SNES. And now we got Mario Kart 64, baby. Woo, baby. My dumbass only recently found out that this is the second Mario Kart game. I don't know how that happened. I do have Game Boy Advance games. They're in a bag though with my Game Boy SP, it's pink. I don't know where it is, though. It's somewhere in one of these shelves. I'll find it, though, and I have a bunch of games for it. That's the reason that I failed history junior year. Because my friend Thomas started bringing his 3DS to class to play the new Pokemon. And I went, and none of the teacher said anything. I went, we can bring handheld gaming to class and nobody cares? So I brought Fire Red in my pink Game Boy SP. And every day in history class, I'd pop it open, and I'd just play Fire Red while class happened. And I failed horribly. I was also doing the Beam Twitter account. The Beam plus Pokemon Fire Red are the reason I failed history. And then the second year, I was number one in my class at history. Good times, good times. We got... Ooh! Now this is Man Game. Ooh, ooh, ooh. We got the Man Game right here. The ooh. Where it's, what is it, dinosaurs versus, like, it's such a weird concept for a game. I don't get it. Turok 2, Seeds of Evil. This is the one Bryant would play a lot. I was never super into it. Bro, why is this tweet doing, follow me. This tweet's got 33 likes in 12 hours. Bro, I need 33 follows, not likes. He clearly didn't read it. God says you can redesign the penis, redesign it. Yes. Yo, you got speedruns on the... The console is not the SM... It's the Nintendo's... It's the N64. The game is SM64. Here's another war crime chat loves to hear. Just like me having Zelda Link to the Past and never playing a Zelda game. I have Banjo-Kazoo... Wrong scene. I have Banjo-Kazooie and have never played it. Actually, that's a lie. I played it for 5 minutes one time and that was it. Oh, that's why I didn't respond to you. Respond. The chat I'm looking at for this camera froze. Let me refresh it. There we go. We must see how you'd make the penis. I don't know. Maybe more polite. Like, put a hat on it. Maybe a little hand going like, hey! It's just, like, truly the word phallic describes it, you know? A true phallic object. You've never played a Zelda game? No, I haven't. And I have all of them. I have all the originals. They just look so goddamn boring. The OG ones, and especially Breath of the Wild. Oh my god. No, the music, phenomenal. I will say that. We have Wayne Gretzky 3D hockey. Also, like, should we do that, chat? Would you watch that? If I was like, hey, chat, we have 30 days.
We're going to, at least for 30 minutes, play every single game on my shelf. Is there even enough time in the month? I don't know. We're going to find out how many games I have. Somebody keep track. So I'm going to make a list of all these games. I used to have one. It may need updating, though. I used to keep... There used to be a games command. There used to be a games command. It's not there anymore. The dock is still there that it would link to. Ooh, this is what I grew up playing. This, I would sit on my uncle's floor at my grandma's house. And I would play this with Ethan and Alex. This is memories. We'd play Power Rangers Rescue on the Nintendo 64. And then afterwards, when it got late, we'd watch Most Extreme Elimination Challenge. Good times. Good times. Any other questions? Safriya, any other questions? Other than the am I gay question that you came out swinging with? That's like our first question of the day. Damn, you list of like what use for stream isn't in your like under the stream thingies? Huh? What? Wait, what? What's not under the stream? Oh, that hasn't been there for a while. That hasn't been there for a while. There you go. Exclamation point PC. We're not reviewing the Steam library. I already said no. Where Animated Squares used to have a list of what you used for it. Oh, for like streaming? Yeah, it's just exclamation point PC now. It's missing a couple things, but it should be all there? Possibly. Now we're getting to the deep Mario 64 games. You got Mario Tennis. I've played the new one. I've not played this one. Then we got Boom Bam Bop. Now these, they keep remastering Pokemon games, right? Making new ones, remastering others, making them HD. I don't comprehend how Pokemon Stadium has not been remastered. I have number one and also number two. We're getting to like my top four Nintendo 64 games. I would put these at spot two and four. Okay? Pokemon Stadium 2 was so good. How have these not been remastered? Pokemon Stadium is so fun, so good, so simple, so easy to make. Then you have, what's crazy is I've had this my entire life. Super Mario 64, right there. But we didn't start playing it until a month ago. Because I'm an idiot. You're an idiot! And then, I introduce you to the number one. My childhood, played it nonstop. I've played it on this channel. One of the only games on this shelf that I've ever played on the channel. And that is Kirby 64 and the Crystal Shards. Absolute childhood maker. I'm going to put these back on the shelf. And next we'll go through, I guess, the Intellivision ones. Because there's not a lot of those. Review your Steam library. Fuck it. Is Sun single? That is a question I get a lot because I am a Chad. And it is one of the few questions I am not comfortable. But I appreciate you asking respectfully. That is something I didn't use to keep private, but then chat was weird. So, some chatters know, some chatters don't know. That is one of the rare gray spots. If you're single, but are there any hot single MILFs in my area? Oh, dude, there was MILFs all the time growing up. Missouri makes MILFs. MMM, that's what I'm saying. Oh, shit. Oh, God, I forgot this was all holding each other up. Oh, no. Everything is bad.
I forgot it's all like tension held up. So, are we good? Are we good, boys? Good. Woo! Alright. Let's go to the PS1. Let's skip the Intellivision.
Nobody cares about the Intellivision. Am I a hot single MILF? Obviously. So, for the PS1, we have, coming at you, one of my favorite games, Crash Bandicoot. Grew up on that, loved it. I think it's one of the first games I ever played on PlayStation. I was insane at it. Now that I'm an adult, I don't know how I was. I don't know how that works. You got motherfucking Asteroids. I also have this for the Atari. I don't know where it is. It's somewhere on that shelf. Oh, there it is. There we go. Got Boom Bam Bob. Got Asteroids OG. And Asteroids slightly newer. What are my opinions on Gushers? You mean like squirters? Good for them. Oh, you meant the candy. Oh, I don't like them. I don't like fruit candies. Why am I going? I'm walking around so much. I'm really showing my ass. Yeah, I knew you meant the candy. I was farming. God, how did they have a Namco Museum for the PS1? Isn't that crazy? Volume 3 of the Namco Museum for the PS1. Aren't they on, like, Namco Museum 40 at this point? And then here's another war crime. I have the entire set of 3 discs for Final Fantasy VII for the PS1, and have never played it. Yeah, there's disc 1, disc 2, and disc 3. It's a chunky boy. Next question. Next question, chat.
AMA. 360 games, I used to have a ton, but I've lost them over the years. I'll show you what I got. Show you what I got. Show me what you've got. I look like a librarian marching back and forth and organizing. Yeah, what's your favorite brand of organized crime?
Someone's... take away this man's platform. Okay. Let me go through my 360. So this is where I really started to be a gamer. When I got my 360 and my copy of Split Second. This is when gaming happened. I wasn't a GameCube guy. I only played Nintendo 64 because my grandma and my uncle had one. But this was it. This was my childhood. This game came out, as well as something else very... I think it was the new Halo. But my mom got me this. I don't know why. I think it's because I was playing Need for Speed on my stepdad's PlayStation, so she knew I liked racing games. I had never heard of it, and I put it in and fell in love. It is the Split Second. The same copy I have had for a decade now. Woo! I should learn to throw away things. I should learn to throw away things. Then he got Call of Duty Ghosts pre-owned by GameStop. Thank you, Mr. GameStop. Why is my chat keeps freezing? Sorry. Yeah, sorry I'm not responding to every message. It's pretty neat. Oh, there we go. You can probably sell them for a lot of money. Maybe. How would you make a Split Second movie? It's already been made. Death Race. Look up Death Race. It's got Jason Statham in it. It's got Danny Trejo, and it's wonderful. They made like 5 of them. I think 1 and 2 are good, and after that, they lose the sauce. And it's unfortunate. This was one of the ones that I got. It's scuffed. It's Madden. I forget which one. This was the one I got from the kid, remember? This was the one where the kid scammed me, and then his mom scammed him. And so I got a bunch of games that I didn't even ask for. This was the other game. I've also played this. This and Split Second, I would come home from school and I'd play on my projector wall. Battlefield 3 Limited Edition.
Ooh, we got any Prototype fans? Prototype is kick-ass. Ooh, shiny. Wow. There you go, chat. This is another one. This is one of those. What up, Walden? Got your gifted sub from Zafraya. Kick-ass. What is the meaning of life? The meaning of life is whatever you choose. For me, I picked my meaning of life at about the age of, I want to say 17. I want to say that's when I, like, chose it. That makes sense to me. It was around that age, like 16 or 17. I had, like, an epiphany, and I went and got it. Yeah, and it was boobies. Yeah, it was boobies. Yeah, it was definitely boobies. Boobies. We got Assassin's Creed. I mean, we got the usual suspects. You got Assassin's Creed. Me and Bryant played Halo Reach. We probably have thousands of hours in this game. I got insane at it. Again, it's one of those games that now if I streamed it, I'd be dog water at it. We got Halo 4. Halo 4, Halo 4 Your Soul. Mass Effect, this is one that Bryant played a lot and everyone around me played a lot. I thought it looked whacked, so I never played it. Walden with the shiny message. Thanks, Walden. I'm going through my game collection. We started at NES, then SNES, then Nintendo 64, then in television, then PS1. Now we're into the 360. We'll do PS2 last because I have the most PS2 games. And they have some of my favorites in there too. Did I have GameCube? Oh, no. My friends did. I thought it sucked. Which I know is a hot take. People like, all over their GameCubes. I wasn't a GameCube guy. I went Nintendo 64 to the PS2 to the 360 to Xbox One and then all Nintendo consoles. I haven't bought anything other than Nintendo consoles since the Xbox One. Yeah. Mass Effect was huge. Very huge. The only issue with PS2 is when it comes to collecting, there's a lot of shitty games. Nintendo 64 only had 296 games, which is crazy. PS2 has like 5,000 plus, I think it's 2,900 game titles, and a lot of them suck. A lot. I got Halo 2, Electric Boogaloo, only on Xbox. I got, oh yeah, these are new additions. I don't know where to put them. Kappa sent me this. He started the Wii collection. I didn't have any Wii games. Chat, if you want to add to the collection, if you have old shitty games. Dude, Kappa sent me this physical copy of You Don't Know Jack for the Wii. Wii Fit Plus for the Wii. Family Feud 2012 edition for the Wii. That's when the world ended, right? Left 4 Dead 2. This is, again, another one that I've played religiously growing up. So many hours into Left 4 Dead. And this is my one GameCube game. I don't know when I got it. It also is another war crime because... Oh, it has Ranch on it still. This is Super Smash Bros. Melee. I've never played a Smash game for more than 5 minutes. But here's the thing. When you open it, all you get is Shrek Treasure Hunt. I don't know how that happened. This is also one of the ones I got from scamming that kid on accident because his mother was upset with him. So there's the 360 games. Now let's move on to, I guess PS2, or no, PSP, then PS2, then Switch. I also have a lot more games in my living room. I should probably do a whole YouTube video about this. I think people would find that interesting. The full. Yeah, don't look at my ass. I know it's supple and beautiful. They don't gotta be weird about it. Yeah, PSP. Ooh, we can also go through that. Hold on. It's gonna be proper. Okay, proper. We should probably make this a command, mods. Exclamation point games, so we don't have to make the document this time. I'll just highlight this and then make it the exclamation point games commands. So for the PSP, these were a gift from my great aunt. Still alive, by the way, still kicking. God love her. The PSP. Now, I was a PSP Andy. I never had a DS. But I had a Game Boy Advance, Game Boy SP, and a PSP. PSP was pretty baller, but there was one problem. It would eat your games. It had, like, you have the cartridge, you have the disc, but the PSP introduced the disc cartridge, which is by far the worst way to play a game on planet Earth. And when you would put in the game, it wasn't a nice slot. It was this mechanical chomping device. And it had hooks in it and clamps. It would get shit stuck in there and it would like pull on the cartridge if you did it slightly wrong. Oh my god. For that, as a kid, I had Cars 2, a Need for Speed game, and NBA. Now, I have Madden 08. Grand Theft Auto Vice City Stories, so fuck you, TLI was there first. I also have this for the PS2, but we'll get there. From Russia with Love 007. Scarface Money Power Respect. And Suck on My Balls Tactical Strike. So yeah, I have Madden 08 and Madden 15. I have Madden 15 for the 360, Madden 08 for the PSP. I have Madden Stream. I guess these count as games, right? Hold on. They have a story, at least. We're sharing stories today. So, does anyone know what these are? These nuts. Got them. So, growing up, I had about 2,000 Pokemon cards and about 1,000 Yu-Gi-Oh cards. And I was growing out of that phase, and I decided to sell them. But before I sold them, me and Bryant went through, and we each made our own Yu-Gi-Oh deck. And so every time I move, and Bryant helps me move, we find these and we play a quick game. One of my favorite traditions. Our other tradition is finding batteries. Like, when a battery dies, Bryant throws it at my closet. And he goes, so when you move, we get to find all the batteries. And that does happen. I go, Bryant, look, battery. He goes, I threw that. So the green one is Bryant's. This one is mine. God. Oh, these are just full of mold, probably. How do I sleep on an empty stomach? You don't. Just get a snack. Why do you gotta sleep on it? Unless you're having a surgery, in which case that is tough. I would say then drink some water. You're allowed to drink water before a surgery. They want you hydrated at least. They're going to put a catheter in. Can't pee on them. Drink some water. That'll help you. A lot of people always think they're hungry. But if you simply, like, just drink water until, like, your body's like, hey, we're full. Down a quick bottle of water. That helps a lot of people, I know. What kind of deck did I end up making? So, that sounds like a salt with batteries. No, it's a salt and battery. Dude, my chats aren't updating. The chat that I have for you guys just isn't updating. Do you got any Magic Gathering cards? No. I was never into Magic. I was into Yu-Gi-Oh! And Pokemon. And then I sold my Pokemon cards and I kept these Yu-Gi-Oh! Ones. Me and Bryant never knew how to actually play either because we're idiots. So we'd like make up our own rules. So this deck is probably not built to any kind of good way. Let me see if I have anything good in here, though. There's Avalanching Azza. Let me find my favorites. There's Fissure. Need half this. We'd also stack our decks before instead of shuffling. So we could have, like, the perfect moves like the TV show. There's the Infernal Incinerator. I wonder if any of these are rare. There's got to be some rare, right? Heavy Mech. I also... Okay, here's a cringe fact. I heard Magic Gathering. I've never had Magic Gathering. Bryant does, though. Any cards in that deck? Yeah. Again, we've made up our own rules with it. And it also, this wasn't necessarily our deck. This is the cards we wanted to keep that we were, like, attached to. Can we say Madden yet? Yes, you can say Madden. I forgot you couldn't say Madden before. I had a can of Diet Ginger Ale somewhere in my house, so either I'll eventually find it and forget I put it there, or someone who lives in the house, the future will be right. Yeah, me and Bryant did that all the time. We just throw shit in the closet and be like, we'll find it later! Never find it later. Do you have anything interesting in here? Mighty Guard. Toon World! I love the Toon cards. VWXYZ Battle Cannon. Whoa. Love VWXYZ Dragon Catapult Cannon.
Megamorph was rad. Fiend Comedian. Spirit Ryu, Gatekeeper's Assailant. Mountain.
Oh, the Elemental Heroes I loved.
Is Brian from Wisconsin? Bryant's with a T. He's from Missouri, right here. I'm the best man at his wedding next month in Colorado. I'm excited. What should I do in Colorado other than hellacious amounts of drugs?
Kind of works? Yeah, there you go. Just like I said, just drink some water.
It'll at least help you get by. A lot of people, times you think you're hungry, you're just dehydrated. If you drink water and you're still, like, as hungry, then you probably need to eat. I'm not dying, but it's still 1:30 a.m. You can stay up late occasionally. Wouldn't be the end of the world. Unless... Dude, the Spark Blaster! Sorry, I keep not seeing what chat's saying. Alright, I'm gonna change what chat I'm using. Hold on. Let me close this. There we go. Yeah, I know. I think Teal Hollow 1 is from Wisconsin, though. And now he lives in Oklahoma. Swift Sky of the Fierce Knight. You gotta say him like that. Elemental Heroes Sparkman. I love the Elemental Heroes. So good. Karibo. It's all the cards from the show, basically. Because I loved the show. I had all the movies.
Sweet Home Oklahoma.
Oh, that's Brian's. We can go through... I don't even know what's in Brian's deck anymore. We haven't done this in so long. Also from Oklahoma. I grew up in Oklahoma. Good times. Good times. I went to Tinker Air Force Base. I was an Air Force brat. That's why I know about the... So Luna probably knows about the Bridge McDonald's. One of my favorite places growing up. Good time. Oh, Brian's cards are higher quality than mine. They're like a different size. What the fuck? Why are his in perfect condition? These don't have any problems. Did he get his cards from somewhere else? Look at these. These are in like... These are 15-year-old cards, by the way. That have been mistreated. Well, let me compare. Hold on. Let me pull, like, any card out of here for you. Like, compare these two. One of these things is not like the other. It's all, like, folded and shit. Why did Brian take way better care of his cards than me? And I didn't even know. His are in, like, great condition. I could probably make some moolah, bro. I could probably move some product over here. Sheesh! Boy, they didn't have so much sentimental value. Ah! Alright. Now, we're gonna go through the PS2 chat. Are you ready? Don't forget, you can also ask me anything. Anything, chat. What do you want to know about me?
What advice? Not what advice. I don't want advice from a guy like me. Not in a bad way. Woo, this is gonna take a second. Alright, chat, I need you to be patient. I got a lot of PS2 games. Ugh, stack them up. You ever move back to Oklahoma? No. Maybe. Because my dad lives there.
I don't know. I don't know where I want to end up living. But Oklahoma is kind of dog shit. In a different way than Missouri. Missouri is one kind of dog shit. Oklahoma is all other, like, different scent of dog shit. In my opinion.
Chat, we're gonna keep stacking this mountain up, see how high it goes. I only live there because my dad was in the Air Force and he was stationed there. I travel there occasionally because my dad's still Cox is in the Air Force, he just likes it. Fucking. Okay, second chat. I'm going higher. PS2 games must go higher. God. I was gonna say, if you did, then Teal and Luna could start their own gamer house. That's always been an idea. I don't know if I'd ever actually do that. You gotta be in a whole mood for that. Oh no, stream is crashing. Okay. Woo! Okay, there is my PS2 collection as it stands right now. Please God, do not fall.
Alright, how are we doing, chat? How are we holding up over here? Woo, try not to move too much and just tip it. Alright, anyway, let's go through here.
What do we even call that gamer house? So this one's unmarked. I don't actually know what this is. Could be nothing. Oh, no, I played this a lot growing up. It's Tiger Woods PGA Tour 2003. That one was played a lot of that. Me and my stepdad bonded a lot over that.
Woo!
OG God of War? I would do it in Austin. I'm not a huge city guy. But Austin is so dope. Austin or San Antonio. Texas is awesome. It's so open. It's got its good cities and its bad cities. Fucking, I love Austin. I really do. Oh, Omega Lil Austin. What's wrong with Austin? This one, another one. Grew up playing a fuck ton. If you know, you know. The OG Spider-Man games. I think Spider-Man 2 was better, though. The video game. Need to play those. Texas has some. Listen, you haven't been to like, dude. San Antonio is baller. Amazing Mexican food, great culture. Lots of open space, but then you got the nice city amenities. We have the Grand Theft Auto PS2 trilogy. You said something about McDonald's Bridge. Yeah, it's in Vinita. Yeah, Miami, Oklahoma is where I'd go for the monster truck rallies. Bonita, Oklahoma was the McDonald's Bridge, which is now the, I believe, Whiteman Turnpike Bridge. They've renamed it because now it's got multiple restaurants, but it used to just be that sun. But wait, was I talking about politics? Wait, what did I say that was political? Liking Texas? Political. Yeah, we got the entire trilogy. Got Vice City, San Andreas, and GTA 3. Is that really a trilogy? Why would you start your trilogy at number 3? That's so weird. It's number 3, Vice City, and San Andreas. Huh. Okay. Woman. Because of politics? Oh, no. They have... Again, if you've been to Texas, no. Like, you're painting with a big old brush. Yeah, you've got the empty, like Houston and Dallas. Oh, yeah. Like Austin, San Antonio. Oh, beautiful, diverse, great people. I mean, it depends what you're talking about, but like there is, if you go to one city in Texas or another city in Texas, it's a huge different situation altogether. All right. Woo! Did anybody in chat play this? I played not this, but Simpsons Hit and Run. Simpsons Hit and Run was so much fun. I never played this one, though. I should probably stream this. A lot of people stream it. State laws, though? True! Now, see, if you're just talking city to city, there is incredible places, like, with their own set of statutes and stuff like that. But, yeah, Austin's dope as fuck. Dude, no income tax? Let's go? Oh, chat, we know why I play this, right, brother? We got Big Mother Truckers. Big Mother Truckers for $8. Keep it in the family. Oh, ew. Why would you say that? Dagon it. Truck Jackers, outhaul your next of kin. We should stream this sometime. We really should do like a PS2 month and just slowly go through my entire catalog. Like we spin a wheel, you know? Kind of like, what would we call it? Wednesday Wheel Night? Nah, that would never work. Who would watch that? Some of these are still like sealed in different ways. We got Crash Nitro Kart. That's a $13 game if you're wondering when I bought it, but it's an NFT, so it's worth even more. Never played this though. I didn't even know they had racing games until I bought that. Woo-hoo-hoo! Now we're going back. I kind of want to stream some Guitar Hero. If it wasn't for constant DMCA, like, problems. Because didn't they also delete the directories for a lot of these because of DMCA? I can't remember. Dual Guitar Shredder. Oh my god. I was so good. Dude, if you could do Freebird on expert mode, 100%, I could. I could. And I did. I was absolutely insane, bruv. Absolutely nutty. Hey, Guitar Hero 2. Oh, we're going through the twos. Hold on. Wait. Did I do this on purpose? Look, hold on. So chat, follow me, right? You looking at me? Look, we got Guitar Hero 2, Silent Hill 2, Tony Hawk Underground 2, Star Wars Battlefront 2. Bro, what am I making my own trilogy right now? What the hell? Anyway, all great games too. Great sequels. Silent Hill 2, I've played a little bit. I think it kind of sucks. I'm not gonna lie. That man was some weird guy. Hey, sorry I'm late. No worry. How you doing today? We're just going through my game collection today. And then we're gonna play some games later. We have Tony Hawk Underground 2. This is another childhood favorite that I play at my grandma's house all the time. It's got the Jackass crew. Before I knew them as the Jackass crew and Tony Hawk and all his boys. This game's story is amazing. I've also streamed this on the channel. This is one of the few retro games that I've streamed on this channel. I've done Kirby 64, this, and James Bond Jr. I think those are the only three, like, pre-Xbox 360 games I've played. But why are people still liking this tweet? Give me follow, smile. Anyway. I've never played this. Apparently, people like jizz over this game, like as the one that they're like, man, I wish Star Wars would go back to that, right? Isn't that a thing? Or am I wrong? I might be wrong. I know it's Star Wars something too, right? Oh! I would play this at my great grandmother's house on her PC every time I would go by there. My mom would get annoyed. She'd be like, hang out with your grandmother. What are you doing on her computer? But I don't know why. She had one game and it was this. She wasn't even a gamer. She didn't play video games. But for some reason, her computer had this. Like, it was pre-installed with it? I don't know. Maybe it was the way that they shielded the game. Oh, this could be fun to play. We have Nickelodeon's Avatar The Last Airbender. That could be fun to play. Is that a good game? I know it's the easiest game to 100% with achievements on the 360. I know that's a thing. Sorry, I need some liquid. I'm doing a lot of just chatting today, obviously. Let's keep going. One of the better Need for Speed games, you've got Need for Speed Undercover, which has... Oh, go deep undercover? They know what they're saying. Hold on, look at this. Look at that. Top left, go deep undercover. They got Booba. Wait, is the main character in this game a woman? What are they doing? Oh, there's no book in there. What's the point? I can't read. I was trying to read about the game. I've never really been into Mortal Kombat. I'm a Street Fighter guy, but I have Mortal Kombat games. Actually, one of those games I went through earlier should have been Mortal Kombat. I think I'm missing one. Or maybe it's in the console. Oh, no. Mortal Kombat's in my Super Nintendo right now. I'm pretty sure. If it's not, then I'm absolutely missing a game. Woo! Isn't this what Teal just finished playing? Or was that a different one? Was that Ratchet and Clank? This was Going Commando. Alright, that's not even a pun. Like, all their titles have, like, puns or innuendos. But this one is just, like, you're going commando. That's not even that clever. He's playing every one of them? I didn't even realize that was his thing. Pick an ass one planet at a time. So aggressive and shiny. Big guns to take on the challenge. See, I saw clips from the new one, and it didn't look to be as tongue-in-cheek as it used to be. Are they trying to make it more family-friendly? How many games do you have? I'm going through! These are the... After we go through these, this is it. Except for the ones that are in the living room. But that's a whole other rat's nest. These are just the ones that are technically in my collection. Oh, this one was awesome! The Incredible Hulk. Is this the one that I played? It is! This one was just the movie. I love video game, the movie, the games. Or the movie, the games. A lot of people hate them. Love them. They're always dog shit, but you know exactly what to expect. Because as a kid, you're like, I get to break out of the facility like a Hulk does in the movie? And I get to have trouble with my father? Oh no, I bet there's a love interest in the second act. So that was a really good time for me. This is the last of the collection. The PS2 is the largest chunk of it. So this is my favorite, like, brand of video game, and unfortunately it died. Very sad. And I'm talking about Street. This one is Street Football. My favorite is Street NBA. These, dude, when I, like, Blitz and Street were way better than 2K could ever be. 2K NBA, Madden, that shit sucks. I don't know what happened, but they stopped making these and they don't get any remasters. But Street NFL, so I still play this every week with the boys. Timeless. Why is the music all sad? There we go, I guess. Chad, did you fart? It just smells like mildewy and dusty because of all this. Oh, I have another Madden? Okay. So we now have a Madden for PSP, Xbox 360, and PS2. There's so many of these. Yeah, that's the... Yeah, Madden 07. Who is this on the front? Seahawks. This would have been for 2006. Who is this? Chaz, do we know who that is? It would have been the 2006 because they released them early. 2006 Seahawks. Like a running back? Hold on. Is that Sean Alexander? No, it's 37 I'm looking for. Who is this? No, he was a running back. Sean Alexander, at the time was number 37, is an American former professional football player for the Seahawks. Cool. He's from Florence, Kentucky. Oh, this is going to be like Florence, Italy. All right. Cool. Chat, have you ever played Madden? Does my chat play Madden? Are you Madden? I feel like everyone played... Like Call of Duty, Madden, Halo. You know, just like the default ones that your parents got. You can be like, these are the games that men play. That's not how it happened. Spider-Man 2, this is the one I really liked. I didn't like Spider-Man 1. It felt like it was missing something, and Spider-Man 2 solved what it was missing. What are you guys' favorite games? Like on console? Does anybody in chat have any PS2 memories, or is chat too young? NHL Faceoff. Never played this. This one's another one just in the collection. Played your dad's Call to you when you were 10. You have a demand? What is your demands? What is your demand? Dude, I just talked for 3 hours straight. I forgot what kills my throat. Make you mod? Oh, listen, this is AMA, not demand MA. Woo! Now we're getting into it. Boom. NBA Street. This shit is the best way to play a sports game. They nailed it. They got lightning in a bottle, and they stopped making them. They only went up to number 3 on football and number 2 on NBA. And it makes me feel bad.
such amazing memories nobody will have because they don't have a PS2. I also have multiple copies of it just in case it goes bad. Like, I have Space Jam 3 times. I have 2 of NBA Street and 2 of NBA Street 2. If you add that up, I have like 8 NBA Streets. What is this? Dude, I don't know half the games I have. This is a problem. Should like do it. I should do a tier list. A lot of garbage, but children love dumb shit. Yeah, I got Nintendo 64 memories, Super Nintendo memories, PS2 memories, Xbox 360, Xbox One, and then the modern Nintendo era from Wii on. Wii, Wii U, Switch. PS2 was a big one for me, though. Especially because PS2 is timeless. And I have 3 PS2s, actually. And me and my friends will still play the PS2. Oh, listen, chat, this one was because, like, I had a sister, and she liked a girl. This isn't mine. It's not mine. Okay, it might be mine. Woo! Beat the Heat. The only beach volleyball game for PS2. Is that true? That cannot be true. The boobs aren't triangles. They are very round. They figured that one out in the PS2. Sizzling soundtrack. Sum 41. Pink. Kylie Minogue. Fresh Maka. Suburban. Sprung Monkey. And many more. The only one I remember those is Pink. Because Pink is still relevant. Addictive. 2-on-2 beach volleyball action. They knew what they were doing here, right? They knew. They had to know what they were doing, right? This is not about the volleyball. This is... Dude, they're not even playing volleyball in the art. There's not a single volleyball. Oh, there's one. You really gotta... Maybe I'm just being distracted. There's one volleyball I can find. Okay, this is my second Tiger Woods PGA Tour game. I've got 03 and 05. Chat, he's pointing at you. You!
You.
Ah! You!
You!
No, Tiger, you messed up the bitrate. Hold on, I gotta do it again.
You!
Oh, the disc is loose. Oh, there's a free one! Wait, are you shitting me? So that's what popped out. But you know what's in there? Another Tiger Woods game! I have 4 Tiger Woods games now! They're making babies! Okay. Wait, is that another game under there? Hold on. No, okay. Dude, they're multiplying. PS2 on PS2 on PS2! They're duplicating. Refresh Chatterino. There we go. Sorry, my chat crashed a little bit. There we go. One's in chat if you're in chat. Now this... This is my top 3 PS2 game. Tony Hawk Underground 2. Dude, sequels on the PS2 were amazing. I don't know if that was them trying to be like, the number 2 is good because you're on the PS2. But Tony Hawk Underground 2. Spider-Man 2. Guitar Hero 2. Street NBA Volume 2. Most played games for me had a 2 in them. Oh, God. You guys remember this dog shit? That movie did not age well. This movie is the B movie, but with a raccoon. Yeah, it's another one of those where you just play the movie, but as a video game. Very cool. Oh, you see it? It's stacking up. Like, slowly entering chat's frame. I didn't even notice that. Oh, this is a classic. Oh, this is... Wait. This is the PS2! 09. Chat, if you don't know how old Tom Brady is, he was already cover art in 09. Let alone Ben Roethlisberger, Tony Romo, Lee Evans, Steve Smith, Frank Gore, Vernon Golston. All 32 NFL teams, 11 backyard teams. I should probably play this, but it's still fully wrapped. With Tom Brady and other... pros as kids. Wow! These are very cute. I have backyard baseball and backyard football.
is climbing into the frame. Oh my god, another... Dude, there's too many. Alright, another Madden. Okay, this one just has one. Okay. Woo! You know what's so weird? Why does every PS2 game have a memory card holder? Did people have hundreds of these? I don't... Maybe it was because you had it... Did people have a memory card for every game? Because that seems like some insane shit. I had a memory card. And you had to delete your life's work just to play a new game. It sucked. It sucked so much. You'd be like, oh, dude, I want to play Tony Hawk. There's not enough space. I had to delete my Dragon Ball Z memory. But you're like, I'm not playing Dragon Ball Z. My friend is. My friend won't know. And then your friend wants to play Dragon Ball Z the next day. He's like, who deleted my save? And you're like, I wanted to play Madden. And then you're not friends anymore. Yeah. Playmakers win championships. That is true. The Falcons are on the front. I didn't know the Falcons were on the front. Good for them. Thank God we have emulators. True. What is a memory card? One second. Give me a second. The NES, the Super Nintendo, the PS1, and the PS2, they didn't come with memory. If you wanted to ever save your game, you had to buy these. And you want to know how much memory they had? Want to know how much memory they had? 8 megabytes of data. But they had two slots. You could have two memory cards. You could probably save like 16 games onto this. Maybe. This is the entire storage. Chonky. Anyway, so maybe, were you supposed to have a memory card for every game? That's so expensive. These things were expensive. I'm not even joking. Like, maybe like 25, 30 bucks a pop. So I don't know why every game had to have its own memory card folder. Like, people were buying a different one for each one. It makes sense that you'd have to do that. But holy fuck. I love the PS2 is so cute though. So simple right there. Like it's the same size as the Switch. It was ahead of its time. The PS2 might be the best console. I'd put it easily top two. I don't want to say it guaranteed because like there's a lot that goes into it. But the PS2, I wouldn't even say it's underrated. Under a lot of people's radar. The PS2 was ahead of its time and still has classic games that... How ugly humans look in Gen 9? Wait, what are you talking about? God, my tummy's upset. I need to eat something soon. Ahem. Alright, let's finish this. We're almost done with the video game tour. They look ugly. Wait, what do you mean by Gen 9, though? Like, the Generation 9 of, like, gaming? Yes. We have Future Tactics, The Uprising. I don't even know what that is. Oh, here's a good one. Here is a good one, dude. I don't think anybody in chat knows what this is. I think you're all too young. This used to be a TV show on MTV. Oh, you're talking about Pokemon Gen 9. Celebrity Deathmatch. This was, like, ahead of its time, Adult Swim content, but on MTV... They would have celebrities fight each other for the fuck of it. This one's got Tommy Lee, Dennis Rodman, Carrot Top, Busta Rhymes, Marilyn Manson, Anna Nicole Smith, and Mr. T. Chad doesn't know who any of those are. It's like, Anna Nicole Smith? Starring Ron Jeremy. Oh, no. Let's spot how many of these have been canceled since this game came out. How many of these are absolute pieces of shit? This game came out in... I'm gonna say
08, 09? Hold on. Alexa, what year did Celebrity Deathmatch come out for the PlayStation 2?
Wait, what? The PS2, was the PS2 out yet?
Fish, you dumb.
Anyway, a lot of fun. You didn't hear? She's all the way in the living room. The mic's not gonna pick her up even if she's 5 feet away. Oh, what is this? Oh, that's aggressive. Blood Omen 2. I have nothing to say about that. That's just a game that I own. A lot of these are just games that I own.
Where do I live?
Again, like, Batman and the Rise of Sinzu. What a dumbass. Like, why? Why does this feel offensive? He's got a yin-yang symbol tattooed on his forehead. Aw. Oh. This is in my top three PS2 games. Amex Unleashed. It's also one of the rare games, again, that I've streamed on this channel. I don't like any of the ATV or MX games, but this one, they struck gold immediately. Amazing. They never made another one like it. And it feels bad. Best soundtrack, too. Put it up there. It's starting to curve, which I don't know how. It's on a flat surface. Oh, it's the games naturally because they're not alternating. Because the PS2s are stronger on one side than the other. Oh! This is the one I always get mixed up with Ratchet and Clank. Sly 2 Band of Thieves. Always get it... Oh, sorry, Mike. Always get this mixed up with Ratchet and Clank. That and Star Fox. Back to Street. We got... Football Street 3. I don't have Football Street 2. I need to get it and complete the trilogy. I need to get back to collecting. I haven't bought a new game for the collection in a while. Unless you count Switch games. Which, oh, we still haven't went through. Fuck. Then we'll be done. NBA Street. There's my other copy. Maximo Ghost to Glory? Okay. Okay, another Maximo. Maximo Army of Zen. So we've got Zenzu and Army of Zen. Okay. A lot of these are dusty. And Power Drone with Woman. And there you go. We're now done with the PS2. Let me shelve these up. Give me a second.
Excuse me, rats.
No, I was about to read your question very loudly, not even thinking about it. Oh, chat. Cozy today? We cozy?
No, they're falling. Oh, shit.
Where is my house?
Alright. Woo! I'm not bad at SM64. How dare you imply otherwise? Alright. Last but not least. Modern era.
We have Mario Party 10 for the Wii U with my only amiibo I own. Cool. Chat knows this. Trials Rising. We bought it the day it came out. We streamed the fuck out of it. Great game. We got Wheel of Fortune Jeopardy. Streamed the fuck out of it. Great games. This one I played off stream. Sorry, chat. Get robbed.
This should be a crime. Why don't people complain about this more? Anytime I open a Switch game after buying it, it's just an unbelievable amount of reinforced plastic for the most crumb-sized game. It feels so wrong. We got Super Mario Maker 2, which I've also played a lot. Not really streamed because chat backseating. Omega LOL. Also, all these didn't come with books. Like, are we done with books? Oh, this one's got one. The Crash Insane Trilogy. Again, streamed that a ton. Dude, I love the Switch. Super Mario Party. This one got a lot of hate, but I loved it. So, fuck you. And 1-2 Switch, one of the release games. But pre-owns. It's cool. It's cool. Alright, and now we're done. Now we are done. That is the Suncracker Collection Welcome. Kanye! Alright, that's all my games. That is all of my games. Did you say you had one of the Ace Combat games once? I think I did. Did I read through one of those?